Hey, if you've ever wanted to start a marketing agency, you might have heard the term SMMA, you might have heard the term SaaS, you might have even heard the term SWAS, S-W-A-S. Well, I'm here to kind of help you understand what the hell all of these things are and what's the difference between them all. So before we get started, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click on the subscribe button here and smash that. I always appreciate your support. And let's kind of hop into it here. So I'm going to start with SMMA. And that stands for Social Media Marketing Agency. So this type of agency is pretty much designed to help out small businesses with social media content, Facebook ads, social media ads, and basically to help them acquire new customers through the presence of social media. So their job is to create posts. Their job is to create ads, typically Facebook ads that would in turn drive leads to their website or to some type of form that would in turn allow the company to gather more leads. And as a result of that, SMMA agency owners, they could charge for their services, which typically is a couple of thousand dollars plus ad spend, which means, you know, whatever ads they're running, they'd have to pay for those as well. But they would get so much money from the client each month as their service for this social media marketing agency. And in turn, the customer would get leads into their business, which hopefully would exceed the amount of money that the social media marketing agency is charging them. So in SMMA, what you're really dealing with is a service-based business, more of a performance service-based business, where if you don't perform, your client pretty much drops you, because SMMA agencies are pretty expensive. If you were to ever hire one of them, it does cost quite a bit for that, which can work out fine as long as the leads keep coming in. However, as soon as the leads stop, guess what happens? The client says, no, thank you. This service isn't working for me. I'm not getting enough money in the business from your leads to help me overcome the cost that I'm paying you. So what happens with SMMA agencies is you have what they call churn, the ability for a client to come on, they stay with you for a few months, and then they leave. Well, the problem with churn on SMMA agencies is once you have a client, that's great, you're getting money from them, but unless you perform, they're going to drop you. And that means you need to go find another client to replace it. So there's really no steady monthly reoccurring revenue there, because everything is performance-based. And this is one of the problems that I see with SMMA agencies is is that it is performance-based. So right now, SMMA agencies are still out there, they're still thriving, but it takes a lot of work to keep that agency up and going, because it takes a lot of your own marketing to go out and find new customers. You have to go through and kind of prove to them that your services work and so forth, and it's kind of a hard business. So right now, from SMMA, people have been moving into SaaS, S-A-A-S, Software as a Service. Now, this is a new type of service that has really become predominantly here over the last 5 or so years specifically, because you start seeing a lot of companies have a lot of success with selling SaaS, Software as a Service. Now, I'm going to give you just a couple of them. Netflix is one of them. I mean, keep this in mind. If you've ever had Netflix, Hulu, any one of these things, Amazon Prime, all of these are software as a service. You pay them $15-$20 a month for your subscription, and in return, you get access to their app, which allows you to stream videos perfectly well, right? Well, that works out really well for the SaaS agencies, because they've developed a piece of software, and now they're able to make money on it every single month. And I'm even going to throw Spotify in there as well. Spotify is an audio streaming software that people subscribe to. For the most part, it works. You have the app, you log into it, it works, and then you continue to pay your subscription. When you don't want the service, you just simply turn the subscription off and the service stops working for you because you can no longer log into the app. Hey, real quick, if you're interested in learning some more about the Go High Level platform and how you can make money, I have a free course in the description below. Click on the link. I teach you 8 different ways you can make money using the Go High Level platform with no money out of pocket. If you haven't signed up for Go High Level, there's a link below where you can sign up and get a free trial. Let's get back to the video. Now, why would people want to do SaaS? Well, let me just start with why people would not want to do SaaS. They wouldn't want to do SaaS because building a SaaS company takes time, energy, effort, and a lot of money. Now, if you think of Netflix, Netflix just didn't poof come on the scene all of a sudden. It took them time to develop that software. It took them time to develop the online streaming apps that they are going to be using to provide the services. Well, that took venture capital, maybe. It took money up front. It took a vision to get to there. Most people don't have that kind of time, energy, effort, and money. Well, one of the things I'd love to tell you here is I actually use a piece of software that's SaaS I'd like to introduce you to, and it's called Go High Level. Go High Level, and I'll go over it a little bit later on, but it's a great software that you can actually use to make money on. That is software as a service. So we pay a monthly subscription to Go High Level, and in return, they allow us to take their software, completely white label it, brand it as our own, and then we could resell that software to other people. Now, why build a software as a service agency when you can rent one, if that makes sense? You know, you're paying a subscription to another company who's already developed this software, and now they allow you to resell it as your own. This is a really great profit potential. You've had profit margins of 90%+ in this particular market. There's a lot of money to be made in this, but I just wanted to tell you that this is how software as a service works. You would typically have to build it, or you can buy some kind of software as a service that allow you to sort of rebrand. It's called white labeling, where you could take their logo off their software and put your logo on. Imagine if Netflix did that. Imagine if Netflix allowed you to take off their logo and put your logo on there, but still use the Netflix software and all other stuff, and then you could resell it. Well, why would you want to be competition for Netflix? So anyway, software as a service is a new, great opportunity for business owners to come along and start an entirely new market to create a software as a service business and help small businesses out, get leads, get customers, kind of the same way social media marketing agencies do, except they do it more organically. So SaaS services really focuses on local services, local business owners, and trying to attract local organic leads. Instead of having leads call businesses that don't answer, maybe they try to email people from the website, they don't get a response. There's a lot of leads that have tried to contact local businesses. You've probably done that yourself. You've probably called and left a message at a couple places when you need some services, and nobody's ever called you back. Well, what happens with SaaS is you can now take this Go High Level software, and you can completely allow it to automate and communicate with all of these leads, allowing the local business to acquire more leads organically instead of having to go the SMMA route, where you would have to go put Facebook ads and go find people and then get people to sign up. And it's a lot cheaper because people are already looking for local businesses. All you need is a system like Go High Level to attract those people, to gather those leads, and then to communicate with them effectively through automations and things like AI. Now, I'd like to kind of go off of SaaS real quick. Hopefully you've got a good idea of what SMMA is. You've got a good idea of what SaaS, software as a service. The last thing I want to sit back and talk about is software with a service, SWAS. It's kind of a new term that you start seeing, and realistically, the Go High Level platform is more of a SWAS platform. Why is it more of a SWAS? Because what you're going to end up doing is when you buy High Level and you begin using High Level to sell to your customers and your clients, you become the service provider. Okay, so it is your software. Typically, you've got your logo on there, your software is on there. You're going to sit back and go out and get clients. You're the person that they're buying the software from. Therefore, you need to provide support for them. You need to be able to help them get their system set up to get them put on Go High Level in order for them to effectively use it. So it's not just you're selling them a piece of software like Netflix and just giving them a username and a password. That doesn't work when it comes to Go High Level. There is some technical capabilities involved. You do have to speak with people. You do have to understand people's needs and the way businesses work and so forth, which is why a lot of people focus on specific niche markets. So you might have chiropractors or doctors or dentists or roofers or plumbers that you deal with, because everybody in that particular type of business has the same type of needs and so forth. So once you understand those needs, you can really craft the Go High Level software platform to those specific needs, which makes it a lot easier instead of getting one client after the other, all with different needs. It makes it a little bit more challenging for you as the agency owner, but it can be done. Now, software with a service means that you're providing software as a service to them. So you're providing software, so you're getting monthly reoccurring revenue, and you're helping to support them. So you're providing a service to them as well by helping them run their business, and you run reports and make sure they can understand that the system, the Go High Level platform, is actually working, and you know, you can help them understand that. But some of the things is they might need extra services along with that. So can you imagine if a small business never had a social media presence? You know, they might want the Go High Level platform to attract leads. They might want them to communicate with their customers and to get them basically more customers organically for free without having to pay for ads. Well, what happens if now they want to start doing social media posting? You know, what if they do want to run ads? That's another service that you can have on top of that. So it's kind of like social media marketing agency combined with SaaS to sort of make SWAS. I'm not saying that that's exactly what it is. I'm not saying that those two combinations actually mean SWAS. It's kind of where they came from. But you can understand, besides the software that you provide for them, you'll also need to provide services to them. And you could charge them for that. Obviously, for having the software on a monthly basis, you could charge them $97, $497, $997. You could charge them whatever you want for it, depending on how valuable the particular service is. If they're getting enough clients, if you're giving them $5,000, $10,000 a month worth of new revenue from these clients you're getting, why would they not want to pay you $1,000 or even $2,000 a month to maintain the service? It just makes sense, right? So with software as a service, it really provides two major benefits. Number one, it provides you steady, monthly, reoccurring revenue, because using your software is no different than paying email every month or paying for web hosting every month. It becomes a utility to the small business owner. They need it, they see the value in it, and they continue to pay you monthly over and over again, which for you as an agency owner, for a SWAS agency owner, it creates monthly reoccurring revenue for you. That's one of the benefits that comes into play with this particular model. Now, the second benefit that you're going to get is you have services on top of that you could charge for it. So maybe the company, besides social media posting, you know, that you they want you to take over social media and, you know, create posts and manage all their social media platform, which, by the way, Go Highlevel has a huge social media planner platform that allows the agency owner to completely connect all the local businesses' social media accounts, to push them to schedule posts, to create posts. It's a really fantastic tool, but you get all of that with Go Highlevel. You don't even need to go create or use another tool to create money from that. You just need to charge the customer more and then utilize the system with inside the Go Highlevel platform to make that happen. Now, besides that, they may want to have a website built or may want to have their website rebuilt. Now, one of the great things about Go Highlevel, any plan that you get offers unlimited websites, unlimited funnels, no web hosting fees. So you can understand if your client is currently paying 20, 50 bucks a month for web hosting and website hosting, you can now charge them to create a website, put it on Go Highlevel, and then continue to run that on the Go Highlevel with no hosting fees. And then you could charge your customer a monthly fee for that as well on top of the existing services. So Go Highlevel has several different ways and revenue streams that agency owners can use to charge for their clients and to make money each month. But you can understand this model is very simplistic. You just simply go buy the Go Highlevel software. You get it configured for your company, you put your logo on it, you brand it, and then simply go out and start talking to local businesses and helping them get more customers. That's really what you're doing. And there's a lot of potential for growth, very high profit margins in this model. But the whole purpose of this video was to just help you understand SMMA, SaaS, and SWAS. Kind of what is the difference between those three business models and why I personally think SaaS and SWAS models are much better than SMMA. Because again, one of the problems that you see with SMMA is the churn of clients. You're constantly having to go out and find new clients. It is good money while they're there. And if you can keep performing, great. You know, but eventually the customer will drop you. I mean, most customers, when they get up to a certain level of customers, they're going to say, well, we don't need any more customers, or we're good, or something. And they're going to stop your service because typically it's costing them several thousand dollars a month. Now, if you're charging them $500 a month for a software that generates and makes the money every single month, they're never going to get rid of that. That's going to be $500 to you. And as an agency owner, when you get this thing set up, it is automated. Very little time you're going to be spending with the client, helping them once you initially get their account set up. The account is just going to work. The software is going to work. The automation is going to work. So this is a perfectly great business model. Now, you can stack this. What I mean by that is when you start stacking your customers, you get one customer, 5, 10, 20, 100 customers, all paying you $500 a month. You could see how much monthly recurring revenue this particular software model, you know, is. So why would you not want to hop in with that? Why would you not want to get involved with a business that runs so well with such a high profit margin that you can use to actually help out small businesses? They're going to thank you for coming in and helping them with this. So I hope the video was helpful. If you are interested in Highlevel, use my affiliate link below. I do get credit for that, but if you do sign up under me, I do provide my support. I will help you out. I will help you get your agency going. I'll give you everything that you need to be up and going in 24 to 48 hours to start taking on clients and start making money. Also, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please smash that subscribe button. I appreciate you and have a great day.